everyone, and welcome. In this presentation, I'll be covering a brief introduction to Blenderized tube feeding. My name is Clancy Bryant, and I'm a pediatric inpatient dietitian at Children's Healthcare of Atlanta. In my current role, I specialize in pulmonology and general pediatrics, and I have many kiddos on commercially available blenderized tube feedings. Our objectives for today include familiarizing ourselves with and being able to describe commercially available blenderized tube feeding formulas, which will be abbreviated as BTF throughout the presentation, and to understand how these blenderized tube feeding formulas compare to the more standard commercial enteral formulas we might be more familiar with. Of note, the use of any commercial images or names is for educational purposes only, and ASPEN does not endorse any particular brand or product. So when we say blenderized tube feeding, what do we mean? ASPEN defines blenderized tube feeding as tube feeding that is used for patients who either cannot tolerate semi-synthetic formulas or who wish to consume whole foods. These formulas are made with a mixture of blenderized food sources with or without the addition of other enteral formulas. For a little bit of formula history, prior to the 1960s to 70s, clinicians would combine foods in a blender and give this to patients via their feeding tube. Then in the 60s, 70s, commercial formulas became widely available and were considered a more affordable, safer, and easier to use alternative than blending foods in a hospital. However, since the 2000s, studies have shown the benefits and improved outcomes of using food instead of formula-based tube feedings, such as longer life expectancies and better tolerance for a very large population of individuals with feeding tubes, which is over 1 million people. So why might we choose a blenderized tube feeding? One reason is just increased consumer demand for a more whole foods product without synthetic ingredients that are commonly found in commercial enteral formulas. A patient might also choose a blenderized feed if they're having trouble tolerating a commercial enteral formula. Blenderized feeds also give the patient the opportunity to normalize their tube feeding experience so they can blend up what the family is eating rather than having something completely separate. A patient may also lack insurance coverage for a specialty formula, in which case purchasing and blending foods at home may be more cost-effective. And finally, we know that nutritional variety is important to overall health, and using a blenderized feed is one way to do that for our tube-fed patients. There have been several studies that highlight the advantages to blenderized tube feedings, one of which is improved tolerance to tube feedings. Blenderized feeds have been shown to decrease gagging, retching, and vomiting, and this is thought to perhaps be due to the increased viscosity of blenderized feeds. An increase in oral intake has also been shown with blenderized feeds, interestingly thought to perhaps be related to the sensation experience when belching, with the aromas of real food being far more pleasant than that of commercial enteral formulas. There have also been studies that show an improvement in stooling patterns, and due to this improved tolerance, many patients are able to wean off of expensive or specialty formulas onto blenderized feeds. Another advantage of blenderized feeds is that they contain high-quality, naturally occurring nutrients from foods such as phytochemicals and antioxidants, and improved fiber sources. And you can also apply the principles of M&T in various disease states to blenderized feeds. So you can customize the foods and macro and micronutrient provision to patients in order to follow any necessary guidelines for something like the renal diet or diet for diabetes. As mentioned previously, the higher viscosity of blended feeds is also a big benefit over commercial enteral formulas. Studies have shown that this helps with improved gagging, retching, reflux symptoms, nausea, vomiting, and dumping syndrome. It's important to note that while the viscosity of commercial enteral formulas is pretty standard across the board, commercially available blenderized feeds range from slightly thick to extremely thick. And an interesting study, the first of its kind really, was published at the end of last year by Weston and Clark. They quantified the viscosity of each commercially available formula, and it provides us a guideline for how much water would need to be added to each particular formula in order to make it a thin liquid to allow it to flow through the tube like a pump like a commercial enteral formula. Now, as the formulation of these commercially available blended feeds changes, this study may quickly become out of date, but it's a great starting place and the only guidelines that we currently have for changing the viscosity for our patients that require a pump. Because the viscosity of these formulas is much higher than typical commercial enteral formulas, it's very important that we as clinicians take time to educate ourselves and our patients on the proper way to administer these formulas in order to ensure accurate calorie and fluid provision. In addition to thoroughly educating patients on proper administration, a clinician would want to consider several other factors before switching a patient to a blenderized feed, including their medical history, any current symptoms that may help be managed by blended feeds, their history of tolerance and intolerance to other formulas, any food intolerances or allergies they have, their lifestyle and whether it lends itself to better to blended feeds, commercially available enteral formulas, any ethnic or religious preferences that might impact the formula of choice, the ability for a patient to obtain and store ingredients, tools needed for home blended feeds, or whether they'd be better suited for commercially available prepackaged blended formula. So let's compare home blended feeds, or something that you might call pureed by G2, where a patient purchases whole foods at the store, blends them at home, makes their own feed at home, versus a commercially prepared and prepackaged blenderized tube feeding. We've covered the advantages of blenderized tube feeding in general, the improved GI tolerance, the use of whole foods, the ability to customize based on food intolerances or allergies or micronutrient needs, and that it may help transition patients to PO feeding. But let's think about the advantages specific to commercially available blenderized tube feeds, which would be a longer shelf life. You don't have to prepare foods daily. Less work. You don't have to prepare each feed. You don't have to shop for food. You don't have to follow a recipe. They're easier for travel. You just pack and go. There's no coordinating food shopping, blender transport, sanitation concerns, refrigeration. They're also generally covered by insurance. They may require a letter of medical necessity, but so do most of the specialty formulas. They're also typically less expensive than your peptide, your elemental, or your hypoallergenic formulas. Now, you, of course, want to take into account that there are differences between the commercially available blenderized tube feeds, including differences in vitamin and mineral content, in the ingredients used, in the herbal additions, and in the viscosity of these formulas. Now, comparing commercially available blended formulas to homemade blends or pureed by G-tube, homemade blends require a lot more planning and preparation. They aren't easy to travel with. You need a commercial grade blender to prevent clogging. You might have to strain the mixture. You also have to maintain rigorous food safety practices, so they're maybe not best for immune compromised patients. Homemade blends also aren't typically covered by insurance because it's just like buying food at the store. And these typically need closer monitoring by a nutrition professional. I say closer because all tube feeds should be monitored by a nutrition professional, but home blends are best when planned in advance to ensure proper micro and macronutrient distribution, calorie, protein, essential fat, and fluid administration. So we've talked all about blenderized feeds, so let's take a quick step back and outline the different types of formulas compared to one another. We have commercial enteral formulas that are liquid-based, so they will flow easily and as predicted through a tube or a pump. They contain synthetic ingredients like artificial colors, flavors, and sweeteners, and they can be administered basically any way you like, via a pump, a gravity feed, or a syringe bolus feed. Whereas commercially available blenderized tube feeds are that mixture of whole foods that are commercially produced and prepackaged. They have a higher viscosity and commercial enteral formulas, so they're best delivered via syringe bolus feeding, but they can be run over a pump or delivered as a gravity feed. It just likely requires some dilution. And finally, you may or may not have to add extra foods or supplements in order to meet micronutrient needs, which is also true for a lot of our commercial enteral formulas. And then finally, home blends are that mixture of whole foods that are prepared at home by the patient or caregiver. They're time intensive from a planning and preparation standpoint. They require closer oversight by a nutrition professional, and just like commercially available blenderized feeds, they'll likely require some dilution to thin out, to run over a pump, or to be given as a gravity feed, again, likely best delivered via syringe bolus feeding. As I mentioned previously, commercial enteral formulas were developed in the 1960s to 70s. They have a defined composition, so each bottle is exactly the same. They're packaged aseptically, so they do not require refrigeration. They offer ready-to-hang closed systems. Their ingredients include things like corn maltodextrin, canola and corn oils, soy and casein protein isolates, natural and artificial flavors. They typically come as standard polymetric formulas, disease-specific formulas, and semi-elemental and elemental formulas. And a few examples include many formulas that we are all familiar with, like Jevity, Nutrin, or Kate Farms. In contrast, your commercially available blenderized tube feeds are pre-made with blended whole foods and some other ingredients, but this often means that each pouch is just a little bit different than the other. They only come in meal-sized pouches rather than ready-to-hang closed systems, and there are large differences between the brands, such as the ingredients used and the micronutrient supplementation or lack thereof. So we can get them through the internet, through a DME distributor, through a home health company, just like commercial enteral formulas, and many are covered by insurance, so they may require a letter of medical necessity. Some examples include Real Food Blends, who has 6 different meal options, Nourish and Liquid Hope, which is manufactured by a company called Functional Formularies, Complete Organic Blends, and their pediatric version, which is made by Nestle, and finally Kitchen Blends, which is made by the DME company Medline. And then finally, homemade blenderized feeds require closer supervision by a nutrition professional, as well as a commercial grade blender. They may also have to strain the mixture in order to prevent clogging. You only have a 2-hour hang time, and it does require refrigeration because it is not aseptically packaged. You create it at home. Food safety is very important, and commonly used ingredients are going to include fruits, vegetables, grains or starchy veggies, proteins, dairy and non-dairy alternatives, and healthy fats. So Aspen has an enteral formula guide, which you can find at the web address at the top of this slide. This guide helps compare and contrast across all of the different commercially available blenderized tube feeding formulas, as well as the other commercial enteral formulas, of course. You can go through and see which ones are organic or gluten-free or non-GMO or corn-free, dairy-free, soy-free, whatever your patient might require. As mentioned before, the macro and micronutrient distribution is different across the different available blenderized tube feeding brands. They range anywhere from 320 to 400 mLs per pouch. Though I will personally caution you from measuring any of these blenderized tube feeding products as a liquid volume because of their very high viscosity, as this can cause a lot of confusion when trying to figure out and prescribe how to run them over a pump. So just keep that in mind when you're thinking about forming your regimens for your patients and when you're delivering education for them. These products also range from 2.7 to 3.6 grams of protein per 100 calorie, calories anywhere from 0.9 to 1.4 cals per ml, and fiber from 0.9 to 1.8 grams per 100 calories. So a really wide spread in terms of protein, calories, and fiber based on the product. In terms of micronutrients, some will require extra supplementation to meet the DRI, which is also very common for many of our commercial enteral formulas, and some will actually far exceed the DRI for some micronutrients, even when using an appropriate amount of the product. I know in my personal experience, overprovision of vitamin A is very, very common. So in summary, we have research that supports improved outcomes with blenderized tube feeds versus commercial enteral formulas. There's a new demand out there for these more whole foods products, and many patients are reporting improved tolerance. Blenderized tube feeds are covered by most insurance now, and we as clinicians have a responsibility to increase our knowledge of and our comfortability with prescribing and managing these types of feeds with our patients and families. Here is a list of all of our references for this presentation today. And this educational offering was provided to you by Aspen, and it is through the support of an educational grant provided by Real Food Blends. So we really appreciate that contribution. Please be sure to visit nutritioncare.org to become a member of Aspen or to find any other educational resources. And you can find us at any of the social media links to the right.